We've all heard of Bigfoot, but have you ever heard of Littlefoot? After a 20-year-long excavation, a mysterious ancient skeleton is starting to give up its secrets about human evolution. This controversial material has come to be known as Littlefoot and is an almost complete skeleton from the site of Sterkfontein. The name Littlefoot reflects the small foot bones that were among the first elements of the skeleton found that stood roughly 130 centimeters tall. Funny thing is, fossils were first discovered in 1924 and was later found from a storeroom in the University of Witwatersrand when researchers noticed that the bones had been miscatalogued. Later, Ronald Clarke, a paleoanthropologist at the University of Witwatersrand in Johannesburg, South Africa, sent his two assistants, Stephen Motsumi and Nkwane Molefe, out to the original site, the Sterkfontein area of South Africa, to see if they could find more, which they did. This almost complete skeleton was discovered in South Africa's Sterkfontein cave system in 1998. Ronald Clarke and his team have spent the past 20 years carefully freeing it from rocky material that had entombed it over millions of years. Study of the fossils showed that this species lived about 3.6 to 3.2 million years ago. A member of the genus Australopithecus and from an elderly female and grouped it in the species Australopithecus Prometheus. Characteristics of this species include upward-oriented shoulder girdle, ape-like arms, and curved hand and foot bones, which proved that they were also used to climbing. The skeleton's relatively small stature and certain skull features suggest it was probably a female of advanced age, with a brain size of about 408 cubic centimeters, about one-third the size of modern human brains. Based on earlier data, many paleoanthropologists thought Littlefoot was a member of Australopithecus africanus, but Clarke argues that a number of features differentiate Littlefoot from Australopithecus africanus, which include a larger, flatter face with a wider distance between eye sockets, larger canines and forward-tilting incisors, large mandibles and slightly concave foreheads. And because of this, Clarke says Littlefoot's features most closely match Australopithecus prometheus, a species proposed in 1948 by anthropologist Raymond Dart on the basis of an occipital that was different from all the other fossils found from Sterkfontein. Differences in teeth wear also indicate Australopithecus africanus was omnivorous, whereas Littlefoot and her kin were mostly vegetarian. Together, he says, this suggests that two species of hominins were living near the caves some 3 million years ago. Pretty interesting, don't you think? Little extra information on Littlefoot is that the dental tissues are really well preserved. She was relatively old since her teeth are quite worn. Some say she apparently suffered a forearm injury early in life as well, but there are no proper evidences. Littlefoot is the most complete Australopithecus skeleton discovered from anywhere, even beating the famous Lucy. And for the first time, they could determine the length of the arms and legs and found out that the legs were longer than the arms, just like us modern humans and unlike the apes. Well, that is all about Littlefoot. Thanks for watching and hope you guys enjoyed the video. For related videos, check our channel out and please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella and see you soon in our next video.